Hello and welcome to EduAspirates, our YouTube channel for competitive exams. With this video, we are beginning our series of videos on Indian nationalism. Let us see what we have in part 1 of National Movement. In part 1 of National Movement, we will learn Topic 1, Previous Knowledge, Topic 1.1, The First World War Background, Topic 2, Causes of the War, Topic 3, India and World War I, Topic 4, Impact of World War on India. To begin with, we shall see a comparison between nationalism and patriotism. Nationalism involves national identity. Patriotism involves social conditioning and personal opinions. Nationalism is little aggressive by nature. Patriotism is little passive by nature. In nationalism, people consider their nation as superior to other nations. In patriotism, all nations are considered as equals. Nationalism unites people against a foreign hostile nation. It unites people against a common enemy. Patriotism unites people for the overall well-being and prosperity of the nation. Under the concept of nationalism, people find it hard to accept criticism towards one's nation and consider it as humiliation or an insult. Under patriotism, there is more tolerance towards criticism and tries to incorporate improvements and changes for the better. Let us now learn Topic 1, The First World War Background. World War I, also known as the Great War, lasted from 28th July 1914 to 11th November 1918. World War I was fought between the Allied powers and the Central powers. The main members of the Allied powers were France, Russia, and Britain. The United States also fought on the side of the Allies after 1917. The main members of the Central powers were Germany, Austria-Hungary, the Ottoman Empire, and Bulgaria. Causes of the war. There was no single event that led to World War I. The war happened because of several different events that took place in the years building up to 1914. The new international expansionist policy of Germany began in 1819. The new emperor of Germany, Wilhelm II, began an international policy that sought to turn his country into a world power. Germany was seen as a threat by the other powers, and this destabilized the international situation. Other causes of World War I were mutual defense alliances. Countries throughout Europe made mutual defense agreements. These treaties meant that if one country was attacked, allied countries were bound to defend them. The Triple Alliance, 1882, linking Germany with Austria-Hungary and Italy. The Triple Entente, which was made up of Britain, France, and Russia, concluded by 1907. Thus, there were two rival groups in Europe. Also, imperialism was a major cause for World War I. Before World War I, Africa and parts of Asia were points of contention among the European countries because of their raw materials. The increasing competition and desire for greater empires led to an increase in that confrontation that helped push the world into World War I. Also, militarism was a major cause of World War I. As the world entered the 20th century, an arms race had begun. By 1914, Germany had the greatest increase in military buildup. Great Britain and Germany both greatly increased their navies in this time period. This increase in militarism help push the countries involved into war. The next topic is India and World War I. India, being a former British colony, played a vital role in helping Britain and its allies win over Germany and allies, a role that is often overlooked. Being a British colony, the Indian Army contributed a large number of soldiers to the European, Mediterranean, and the Middle East conflicts of war in World War I. The Indian Army fought against the German Empire in East Africa and also on the Western Front. They served in places as diverse as France and Belgium, Mesopotamia, Egypt, Gallipoli, Palestine, and Sinai. More than 70,000 of the Indian soldiers who served British in World War I lost their lives. As high as 100 million British pounds was given by India to Britain to fund their war, anticipating dominion status and home rule in return. The British raised men and money from India, as well as large supplies of food, cash, and ammunition collected by British taxation policies. In return, the British promised to award self-rule to India at the end of the war, which eventually was not delivered. The next topic is impact of World War I on India. This topic will be studied as political impact, economic impact, and social impact. Political impact. In India, the return of Punjabi soldiers after the end of the war also aroused political activity against colonial rule in that province, which became the spark for further wider protests. Punjab, which supplied a large proportion of the troops, turned into an epicenter of nationalism after the war. There was a surge of nationalism and rise of mass civil disobedience when the Montague-Chelmsford reforms failed to deliver on the expectation of home rule that had led to popular support for the British war effort. As the war dragged on, casualties mounted and recruitment methods grew more coercive, resentment grew to fuel nationalism. Economic impact. There was a sharp increase in demand for Indian goods in Britain as production capabilities in Britain itself were diverted to the war effort. However, the disruption in shipping lanes because of the war also meant that Indian industry faced inconvenience because of the shortage of inputs that were earlier imported from Britain and Germany. There was excess demand as well as supply bottlenecks. Another result was inflation. Industrial prices nearly doubled in the 6 years after 1914. Accelerating prices benefited Indian industry. Farm prices rose as well, but at a slower pace than industrial prices. The internal terms of trade, ratio of export prices to import prices, moved against agriculture. This trend continued for most of the next few decades, and especially during the collapse in global commodity prices during the Great Depression. Social impact. Between 1911 and 1921, literacy rates increased significantly in heavily recruited communities. This effect is strongest for men of military age, which is consistent with the notion that soldiers learn to read and write on their foreign campaigns. Respect for particular communities who participated in the war grew in the society. The huge numbers of non-combatants were also recruited from India, such as nurses, doctors, etc., leaving Indian society deprived of essential services in a situation where such skills were already scarce in India. More on social impact. Demand for food supplies, particularly cereals, led to rampant food inflation. Exports of cash crops like jute suffered due to the loss of the European market. Meanwhile, rising military demand for jute products compensated for the decline in civilian demand, with jute mills in Bengal establishing monopolies. Skewed income distribution grew even more so. The drain on the Indian economy in the form of cash, kind and loans to the British government came to about £367 million. Social impact was also experienced on domestic manufacturing sectors, such as cotton benefited from the decline in British goods that had dominated the pre-war market. The steel sector benefited as well. For instance, the ailing Tata Steel Mills were handed a lifeline in the form of a contract to supply rails to the Mesopotamian campaign. British investment also rerouted to the UK, creating opportunities for Indian capital. In short, the war economy boosted Indian capitalism in some ways at least. Other points. Crops failed in many parts of India, resulting in acute shortage of food. Forced recruitment into the army in rural areas caused widespread anger. According to census of 1921, 12 to 13 million people perished as a result of famines and epidemic. It was felt that Indian people's hardships would end after First World War, but that did not happen. Mahatma Gandhi came back to India on 9 January 1915. India was denied its promise of dominion status after the war ended. Instead, the country was awarded Rowlatt Act, the Anarchical and Revolutionary Crimes Act of 1919, that effectively authorized the British government to imprison any suspected person for up to 2 years without a trial. This brings us to the end of the video on Nationalism in India, Part 1. Keep viewing, keep revising. The next video shall be uploaded soon.